Imagine being able to travel to planets in our solar system in minutes rather than months. That is theoretically possible with NASA's new Lightspeed engine. Going at light speed is the quickest that anything can go, and if we want to explore deep space, we need to be able to travel at such rates. The planet Earth will not be livable permanently, and if the human race wants to survive, we will have to pack our possessions and move to another world. It appears simple until you consider the expanse of space and the size of the universe. If we do not have enough speed, arriving at our final destination will take an eternity. A NASA engineer may have discovered the solution, the new space engine. So, what is the new space engine? And can we really travel with the speed of light? Keep on watching to find out more. So, what is the new space engine? Finding answers to large issues is a human desire. In his spare time, NASA engineer David Burns has been doing just that. He claims to have developed an engine design that could hypothetically travel to 99% the speed of light without the need of propellant. We could use rockets to go about in space, but the biggest issue with them is the quantity of fuel we'd need to get anywhere, and even rockets have their limitations. Includes the speed with which they can carry a spacecraft. We'll need something that can create a lot of power without using a lot of gasoline, because there are no gas stations in space. In a novel concept for in-space propulsion, fuel is collected rather than released from the engine, resulting in a practically unlimited specific impulse. The engine pushes ions in a closed system to relativistic speeds while changing their momentum by slightly changing their speed. This design is described by Burns as a box with a weight inside that is connected on a line with a spring at each end that bounces the weight back and forth in a vacuum-like area, like space. The effect would be to shake the entire box while the weight appeared to be stable around the weight like a present. Overall, the box would continue to move in the same. The engine then generates force by moving the ions back and forth along the travel direction. This in-space engine is designed to maintain satellite stations operational for long periods of time without requiring refilling, as well as to drive spaceships beyond interstellar distances. Ions move through a closed-loop vacuum line, trapped inside electric and magnetic fields, and are the only moving elements in the engine. This isn't the first time that NASA has considered traveling at the speed of light. The EM drive was NASA's beginning stage into the concept of really trying to develop a faster-than-light engine. Internally reflecting microwaves are said to have been used to generate thrust, against the law of conservation of momentum and other physical considerations. The device has been dubbed the impossible drive by the media on several occasions. Explanations for how the M drive could work go beyond what is currently understood in physics. Despite the fact that nothing can push off of space quantum times vacuum energy, it's possible it's interacting with it. Maybe we've lost our sense of forward motion. Maybe it's a completely new physics. There is no definitive design for this device, and none of the people who claim to have invented it has committed to describing how it may work as a thruster or what elements make it up, making it tough to determine whether a given thing seems to be one. While the new space engine, also known as the helical engine, is interesting, despite the statements, it is unlikely to defy the laws of physics anytime soon. Burns feels his proposal is worth pursuing, despite the fact that it has been regarded with skepticism from certain areas. Burns said, "I'm comfortable with throwing it out there, I'll be the first to say, it was worth a shot." According to the concept of conservation of momentum, which means that in an isolated system with no external influences, the initial total momentum of objects before a contact equals the final total momentum of the objects after the contact, some researchers believe this is not totally conceivable. According to Einstein's special relativity theory, objects gain mass as they approach the speed of light, an effect that must be taken into consideration in particle accelerators. In actuality, a simple version of Burns' notion would be to replace the ring with a circular particle accelerator, where ions are rapidly accelerated to relativistic speed during one stroke and decelerated during the other. Burns, on the other hand, believes it would be more practical to remove the box and rod and instead use the particle accelerator for both lateral and circular motion, in which case the accelerator would need to be constructed like a helix. However, there is one relativity issue in particular. According to special relativity, objects gain mass as they approach the speed of light. If the weight is replaced with ions and the box is replaced with a loop, the ions may move faster at one end and slower at the other. On the other hand, Burns' drive isn't a single closed loop. It's termed a helical engine because it's helical, like a stretched-out spring. The engine speed ions are contained in a loop to relativistic speeds before changing their speed to alter their mass slightly. Burns said, The engine then moves ions back and forth along the direction of travel to produce thrust. The engine has no moving parts other than ions traveling in a vacuum line, trapped inside electric and magnetic fields. The helical chamber would have to be very large. To be precise, it is about 656 feet and around 40 feet in diameter. To create 1 newton of force, 165 megawatts of energy would be required. That is the amount of force required to move a kilogram of mass per second, which is similar to the production of a power plant. As a result, the new space engine has a lot to offer, as well as a fantastic concept for traveling at the speed of light. But can we really travel with the speed of light? When anything moves at the speed of light, its mass increases exponentially. Consider the following. The speed of light is 186,000 miles per second, therefore an object's mass will become infinite if it goes at this speed. As a result, moving the item will need infinite energy, which is impossible. That is why no object can travel at the same speed as or faster than light. So unfortunately we can't travel at the speed of light. There might be interesting findings if we were talking about moving almost just as fast as the speed of light, let's say 90% of the speed of light. For one thing, a person moving at such a speed would perceive a sense of time slowing down. Time would pass more slowly for such an individual than for someone who is not moving. A person moving at 90% of the speed of light, for example, would only experience 10 minutes of time passing, but a still person would have experienced 20 minutes. Time is going to be halved. Aside from that, your range of vision would be significantly changed. The world would appear to you via a tunnel-shaped glass in front of the plane you are flying in. In contrast, the stars in front of you would be blue, while the ones behind you would be red. This is due to the severe Doppler effect, which occurs when light waves from stars in front of you clump together and seem blue, while light waves from stars behind you spread out and appear red. You would only see blackness after a certain speed since the wavelength of the light reaching your eyes would be outside of the visible spectrum. Even with all of the difficulties, traveling at the speed of light would be a once-in-a-lifetime experience. In other words, overcoming the speed of light would allow humans to visit galaxies that were previously unreachable. It would fundamentally change how we travel through space and bring up a variety of new possibilities. You can see how some people are interested in Burns and his helical engine design. If he truly did discover a way to travel at light speed or close to it, he'd be able to do so forever. So once that unfolds, all of our science fiction dreams will be well on their way towards becoming scientific reality. What do you think about the new space engine? And do you believe that traveling at the speed of light will ever become a reality? Let us know in the comments.